What is a quantum computer? How does it differ from classical computers? First, let's see how a classical computer works. A classical computer works with a binary numbering system, and the computer is not convenient with the decimal numbering system. Binary system has only two digits, and it's very easy to process the yes or no based logics. Decimal system has 10 digits, so the yes or no based logics would be more difficult to process, and it wouldn't work. All arithmetic operations are done by the binary system-based logics. See an example of adding two single-digit binary numbers using the yes or no logic. Turn the first bit on if any one of the bit is on. This is an exclusive OR. Turn the second bit on if both the bits are on. This is an AND. For example, 1 plus 0 equals 0, 1. So the logic for the first bit is that if any one of the bit is on, then set the first bit on. So the first bit is 1. So the logic for the second bit is that if both the bits are on, set the second bit on. So the second bit is 0. It gives the answer 0, 1. Another example, 1 plus 1. We can use electrical switches as an input device and lights as an output device. Transistors can be used for binary logic-based operations and turning on or off the lights based on the switch settings. Transistors can be interconnected in particular ways to pass the electric current by XOR and AND operations with two switches. This is a half adder to add two single digits. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. This is a full adder to add multi-bit numbers. This is a connection of 8 full adders to add two 8-digit binary numbers. So computer computes by binary state gates. A mobile phone has millions of transistors inside. A computer has billions of transistors inside. So computer does not like the decimal state. Computers like binary state. How about the quantum state, which has the state of both 0 and 1 at the same time? It'll become crazy, wouldn't it? Binary bit state may be 0 or 1. Quantum qubit state will be both 0 and 1 at the same time. See how the result of qubit number addition will be. As individual digits of input numbers have all possible ways, the result will also have all possible values. Yes, two single-digit qubit number addition will make four possible combinations and return three possible values. Two double-digit qubit numbers addition will make 16 possible combinations, and so on and so forth. This kind of computation is done by all types of arithmetic operations. So quantum computer computes all possible weights in parallel. But classical computer computes only one at a time. See this example. This is a room entrance and it has a maze inside. The entrance is split into multiple paths and has only one exit. The task of the computer is to find the correct path, which leads directly to the exit. Classical computer has to travel each path to find the exit. But quantum computer can travel all paths simultaneously and find the exit immediately. It computes all possible combinations simultaneously, choosing the best one. Database search from billions of records can be done in a single search attempt. Any type of encrypted data can be cracked in a fraction of a second. Robots can move and walk like human by studying all possible movements and learning the best moves. Simultaneous and studying complicated biological formatted data. Classical computer uses transistors to create binary-based logic gates. What does quantum computer use for qubit-based logic gates? This is the answer all quantum physicists and researchers are still searching for. The research is still going on. Let's see the possible choices given by quantum mechanics. Introduction to quantum mechanics. Subatomic particles such as electrons and photons behave in a very strange way. Electron has a property of spin. The spin state may be up, down, right, or left. The spin state will be both up and down, or right and left simultaneously in a particular scenario. Such a state is called a superposition state. Photon has a property of polarization. The polarization state may be horizontal or vertical. The polarization state will be both horizontal and vertical simultaneously in a particular scenario. Light has strange behavior in this double slit experiment. Light without any slit shows normal pattern. Light passing through a single slit is spread out because of quantum uncertainty behavior. Light passing through a double slit shows interference pattern because of the wave behavior of light. Passing single photon at a time in a single slit hits random places, accumulates, and shows the same spread pattern over the time period. Passing single photon at a time in double slit hits random places, accumulates, and shows the same interference pattern over the same time period. How can a single photon, which is not a wave, show interference pattern? Actually, it splits into two photons, passing through a slit simultaneously, interferes with itself, and shows the interference pattern. The photon is in superposition state of passing both slits. The spread pattern of single slit is also the superposition state of a photon, is in all positions simultaneously. The photon is in all places, not in all places, is in one place only, is in two places. It resides in these areas with the possibility of all combinations. The superposition state can be used to create qubits, which is also used in quantum computers. Superposition of particle spin can be used to create quantum logic gates. Superposition of photon polarization can be used. Superposition of photon in two slits can be used. Superposition of photon in particular areas can be used. This is quantum computing. At present, humans cannot utilize such an enormous computational power. These are just fundamental ideas for quantum computer. The exact method of quantum computer is still at the research level. The major problem is that the superposition is collapsed and turned into a definite state when it gets measured. Here may be a possibility that the quantum computer can process all possible logics, choose the best one, self-train, self-study, self-program, evolve, and eventually acquire intelligence. Somebody's going to open the Pandora box soon. Cyberdyne, John Connor, and Terminator can be expected. Canada-based D-Wave Incorporation has stepped into the quantum computer world. They have announced that they are selling commercial quantum computers. It is not a full quantum mechanic-based computer, but it's based on the subset of quantum mechanics, called quantum annealing. You can see this reliability as Google and NASA have brought this $10 million D-Wave quantum computer.